Hello and welcome to the second week of the league races. Second week of the league race. This week we're at Florida Lakeland, USA. I actually qualified in a pretty good position this time.
P8, 101 laps. Follow car number 15 in the inside column.
And let's just not crash. Again, all the information for this league, if you want to join it, and everything will be down in the description down below. This is a quite fun series. Not only is there an oval oval league, there is also a road league and a dirt league that they do run here as well. I do believe there used to be not an open wheel, but a single seater series as well. But because of participation, they closed that down. There used to be four series. I'm forgetting what the fourth series used to be, but they shut it down because of lack of participation.
Okay, Corey, get ready.
Which is fair. Because it costs money to run series, which is a thing I did not know when I first joined leagues and everything like this.
Go, go.
So, being a part of these races and whatnot is something kind of special.
He's still there. Still there. Still there.
Oh my goodness.
Still with you.
Haven't run high all that much.
Still there.
So.
He's still there. He's still there. Clear light.
Can I really? Oh shit. Okay then. I touched the wall.
He's still with you. Keep your line. Still there. Still on the outside.
It's shit, I'm going loose.
Full course caution, watch out.
I saw that coming. And the car gets really loose at the beginning. I guess I could stop that. I tried to, but eh.
We're under caution, pits are closed.
I also didn't want to.
I hope I'm not single file behind car.
I had no idea what he said.
Pits are open.
Well then, that honestly looked like an honest mistake under caution. But pay more attention. You gotta pay a lot of attention. I think he did say something to me, but I couldn't understand what he said. Honestly, iRacing takes mic quality and kind of put it through the shitter. Even with good quality mics. Brake bias. Do I actually have? Yeah, I put it all the way up. Just then, I felt like I put it way too many points.
caution. It's closed.
It's also an open setup series, I should mention, so everyone has to work on their own setups, which I'm no good at. If you can tell from my other official series.
Alright Corey, get ready. Race will resume at the end of this lap.
Well, the thing about that, at least with my self-spin,
the track temperature is rising. It's now 42 Celsius.
At least I didn't spin into anyone, and I didn't hit anything. So, as far as spins go, that's actually pretty good.
Green,
wow.
Let's go.
Bill's kind of blinking bad on my end.
He's still there. He's still there.
You mean Jacob?
Keep this line. Clear outside. Not high. Clear high.
Watch your speed. Pit lane speed limit is 35 miles per hour. Your speed limit in the pits.
Okay then.
The gap in front has increased. It's now about 12 seconds.
That time, that wasn't my fault.
You're last.
No shit. I wonder what happened. I'm actually genuinely curious what happened.
Race car is out. Pits
but thank
closed.
God for that caution.
Race car is out. Line up single file behind car number 56.
Pit stop fuel to the end.
Yellow. Pits are open. We'll need to stop again.
Okay, so I'm not gonna come in. So it was Bill that I tapped. I was thinking that. Like, I barely tapped Bill coming into the corner. I mean, I don't know if I came in too hot or what exactly. I mean, for all I know, that was my fault, me self-spinning in that second time or whatnot. I mean, I don't know if that was actually a self-spin. I guess it kind of was, but I mean, I tapped him barely.
Pits
generally closed. Curious to what came out for that second caution. Oh, I mean, Bill probably caused it, but I'm gonna have to look, see what it was.
We're going green next time by.
Oh, come on.
Hey, Brad, are you okay?
Yeah.
That wall hit was totally on me, but it was just... The reason why I said, oh, come on, that could have been easily avoided. I just was pushing a little bit too hard. At least it doesn't feel like it gave me too much damage. Yeah, we should be fine. We just don't want to be hitting the wall too much.
The lap time was at 22.7.
Say Jacob's doing a good job at defending.
Car on the outside. Car with your line.
Got still the there. Four on our outside.
Clear on the outside.
Did I squeeze him a little bit too hard? I feel like I might have. Anyways, time to focus back up on the 11 car.
All right, Corey, the next car is Houston. Lap time was 22.8.
I definitely feel like I'm losing pace behind this 11 car. Like, I want to get past him, but I don't want to be overly aggressive. Holy shit, okay, this... Whenever they start blinking, I start panicking.
Stay high. They're still there.
Alright, I'm not that fussed with giving up that position, because I know he's quicker. Is it me that's blinking? I feel like I'm the one that's blinking now.
Eighth place.
Yes, I'm the one that's blinking now. Goodness, snuck that in.
P9. Gap in front has increased to 0.7.
Now let's try to keep the pace and prove why we should be in front. Ninth might be our top position, unless something happens up front.
Last lap time was at 23.0. The gap in front is now 1.5 seconds.
Now the real question is,
okay, Corey, lap times are pretty consistent.
If there's green flags, pit stops, when to take them? Which I'm having a feeling after all of the yellows we had, which granted is only about two. There was only like two. Yeah. All the yellows. In reality, there was only two.
The gap ahead is now 2.0.
To be fair, the yellows feel like a long time around this track, I do believe. But, with that being said, when do we pit under green? Definitely undercuts do not exactly work all that well, I find, because the yellows can definitely screw you. That corner wasn't all that great.
Front is now 2.1.
let's try to keep P8 in sight. Just in case he makes any mistakes we could possibly try to capitalize on. Let's not try to push for the position, but at least let's try to keep pace enough to where he doesn't pull ahead. Too far ahead. You know, out of sight.
Was at 23.2.
Hitting already?
V8.
I mean, I guess we are running a bit low on fuel. And the tires are feeling a bit worn out. But, I mean, we're not even about halfway there. I am thinking about pitting here relatively soon, though. Car's definitely getting tighter on corner exit.
The gap in front is now 2.9.
Yeah, and I'm losing time to the car ahead. I'm gonna pit whenever we're about 1 gallon remaining.
Okay,
or around lap 60.
Yesterday, 30 laps of fuel left. Lap times are pretty consistent. The gap in front is increasing. It's now 3.6. The lap time was at 23.2. The gap in front is now 3.9. That was at 23.1.
Yeah, he's about 2 seconds away. I might pit a little bit earlier.
The gap in front is now 4.3. The bell is closing in. The gap is now 6.5.
Yeah, bell's closing in. I'm just losing pace all out. This is going to be 58 coming into 59.
1 gallon remaining. Sixth place.
One more lap.
The gap ahead is now 1.9 seconds. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Box now.
Oh, I was far enough?
The leader is pitting now. There's a car approaching. Don't cross the white line. Watch your mirrors.
Car high. Outside's clear.
Just done a 22.7. The gap in front is now 2.3 seconds.
I had a feeling that was gonna happen.
We're under caution. It's closed. Pace car is out. Line up single file behind car number 14. Course yellow, pits are open. The leader's pitting now, watch your speed. You've got plenty of fuel. Box in, a 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, box now. Track temps increasing, it's now 42 Celsius. Pits are open. Okay, Corey, get ready. Race will resume at the end of this lap.
Alright, so I don't know exactly what was going on during that caution. But I mean, we ended up being the only two lap down cars. One lap down cars at the end of it. Actually, I think there was once someone got that got lapped.
Let's see if we can keep it.
I got
P9.
Car outside. Clear outside. Car outside. 3 wide.
But that was absolute bullshit. I don't know how that wasn't a yellow.
6 seconds. temperature is increasing. It's now 44 Celsius. That lap was out 23.2.
Now I need another miracle yellow.
P10, that lap was at 23.0. Come on, Corey, ask this guy. We want the lucky dog position. Gap to Houston behind is now 7.3.
This is such bullshit.
Last lap was at 22.8.
I'm actually a little bit pissed off about all that.
You've just done it, 23.1.
Like, I mean, if we're really gonna do all that kind of bumping and shoving shit, then I mean, I'm all for it. I can get really bumping and shoving and goddamn all that bullshit. I was trying to avoid it. And there's a lap down I did not fucking deserve. Woohoo!
Lap time was at 22.8.
I mean, at least he said sorry. It's just still, like, I don't get it. Like, I try my best not to run into people, yet people seem to already runs into me. I guess me not trying to run into people causes people to run into me. Maybe I'm the asshole.
That was at 22.8. front is now 12 seconds. Lap open was at 22.8.
Like, I don't know if I would have actually... gained ninth place or whatnot, but still.
The track temperature's decreasing. It's now 42 Celsius. You've just done a 23.1.
If you can't try, tell, I'm driving pissed right now. Like, I know I wasn't really racing for all that much. It was only for 10th and 9th. But still, it was just how that happened. It was just,
Your lap time was 23.3.
It just, being careful is what caused me to be dumped. And I don't race these races to be dumped. And yeah, that's not what I race these races for, is not to be dumped.
That lap was at 23.0.
And to actually race people. I haven't been here for about a season, but I just hope that the quality of racing hasn't went down the shitter. It doesn't feel like it because there hasn't been a lot of cautions, but I mean, there was one self-spin from me.
Two laps left. Your last lap time was at...
One from me tapping into the hill, I think.
12 seconds.
And then another self-spin. And then another caution, in my opinion. Another caution that should have been for me getting dumped. But that wasn't an actual caution. We are done with this race.
I swear, Anthony.
I must agree, we are done.
What's your speed limit in the pits?
Because, I don't know, I feel like that race was a crock of shit.
Box in, 5, 4. 3, 2, 1. Box now.
At least on my end. Like, I'm pretty sure it was a good race all around. It was just on my end, it felt like a crock of shit. But you know what? That's how it goes with the racers. The race feels differently from different points of views and perspectives, depending on how it went for each one individual. I'm just in a pissy mood because I got spun, like, twice. I don't know. It definitely felt like twice. Wait, no. When was it? Say, when was a lap? Oh, yes, it was right there. Yeah, that was kind of really, I spun myself, in a sense. Because I... Whoops. Wrong button. Yeah, when was that real slow lap? Wait, really? By the way, I see this. It looked like he generally didn't mean it, but... Yeah, I mean, it wasn't like we was racing each other or anything like that. Whoops. Whoopsie. I'm forgetting my shortcuts. Yeah, like here. Like, that probably wasn't the smartest idea to do it like that. Like, I don't understand how... Wait, is this... Is this right here not considered to be the racing line? I mean... Or did I not, like, come to a stop all the way? Because, I mean, once I actually did come to a stop, I was partially on and off the racing line. Or the... Where this comes. That, I mean, that's tricky of why the yellow didn't come out or trigger. This is... That's probably has something to do with it. Or why I was so low down in the track. But also... Come on! Backwards car! Facing the wrong way! Don't you think that should trigger your yellow? Uh... Well, I guess that's the end of that. Fucking shitty weekend.